third baseman Savannah Moore. This is after a 10-6 loss in the elimination game of the Central Region 2 tournament. Coach, obviously not the result hopefully you were looking for in this tournament, but still an impressive effort to get here. Preseason pick number 10 in the MIAA, the regular season champions. If you could just take a moment to reflect on the season overall.
Yeah, it was great. I mean, I don't think there's very many teams that go from a 25-30 record to win in the MIAA conference, and we won the conference by 4 games, and these kids just really committed to what we're trying to do. This is my second year in the program, and to have kids put their faith in me and my coaching staff and buy into what we're trying to do and make things happen that quickly is extremely rewarding. You never want to lose, and it's tough to lose, and it's tough for things to come to an end, but at the same time, as I told the kids, really the only thing I feel today is just a lot of pride for them and what we've been able to accomplish.
Savannah, from a player perspective, if you don't mind reflecting on this season, that turnaround effort from last year to where you are now, all the things that you and your teammates accomplished.
Honestly, it was kind of surprising. Where we finished last year was just not where we wanted to be at all, so right when the season was over, we decided that everything that we did the previous year, we just weren't going to do, and we started working out in June because we knew we wanted to be here where we are. So,
you bat third in the lineup, and the first inning, your team gets off to a great start. Great start if you want to.
Yeah.
Probably with the 3 runs in the first, get up 4-0. Mankato took over a little bit. But talk about that sixth inning you're at bat there, because your team showed a lot of resilience there in the final couple of innings.
Yeah.
You sparked it with the home run.
Well, we just like to focus on, like, us individually and just making it 60 feet, just getting a hit. No, nobody tries to hit a home run. I didn't try to hit a home run. It just kind of happened. But we focus on doing your small part and each person doing their part. That way we can try and score.
Just one final question for you. What's the takeaway that you will have from this season and then you'll try to spin forward to next year?
I think experience. You know, this was my first regional tournament, obviously my first conference championship, and so now we know what it feels like. So now next year, when we do make it down here, we'll be ready.
Coach, similar question to you, for the program, the success you had in your second year. What are you expecting, wanting the program to be next year?
I want to take another step, and I think the most encouraging part for me today was as kids were in the dugout and the rest of the team was out playing defense, a lot of those kids already talking about wanting to get to work and parts of their game they want to get better. And this experience allowed them to see what their weaknesses are as a team collectively and individually. And just hearing them already talk about their plans, to commit themselves and to continue to work. And you know that when you have kids that are of that mindset, you know, my job is just not to screw them up, because those are the kind of kids you want in your program. And I'm tickled to death with the mentality of the kids we have and how competitive they are. And we do have some weaknesses and some things we have to get better at, but I have a lot of confidence that this group of kids is going to tackle that. And the next step, I mean, obviously this conference is tough from top to bottom, and, we'd love to be at the top every year, but, you know, ultimately getting back here and being able to have a little more success is something that I think will, you know, be our primary goal.
Appreciate it.
All right, thank you.